He's not focused just on the character he's playing. He's interested and compelled to contribute with his wonderful art to original piece of visual language.
Don't call me by her name. I felt a trust and a space within the tone of what he was doing that was unlike anything I had worked on. The trust being that I was trying different things and takes and he was running with all of it. And then the tone being a camera in a room and almost in a theater of like setting just life happening in front of it. And it was so cool as a young actor.
I said to him to try to smell the scent of Oliver in his clothing was a way to possess him. And then we started rolling the cameras. The boldness of Timothy created one of the most honest and truthful erotic scenes I ever filmed. And I hold it very dear because we can find a truth on screen.
What was it like?
A rush. You can feel every blood vessel like spider webbing through me.
There was something heartbreaking about Lee and his feeling of being lost. That I knew that Timothy, with his wonderful wisdom and great talent, tackled beautifully. And he understood how to portray the youth that sprang after the 80s in the 90s from the grunge.
Oh, you trying to run me down? I asked a question. Hear this, you dumb
ho. Hey, don't talk to her like that.
Hey! You're out of control, buddy. You with the store or something?
No, I'm not at the store, but I'm gonna escort you out of it.
Fucking see what happens.
See what happens?
Yeah.
What's gonna happen? Something bad's gonna happen?
Yeah.
Outside! We're going outside!
In the original script, I just felt there was a sort of alpha maleness that might have been great with someone else, you know, but I felt like this will ring untrue if I do it. And I thought if Lee was fragile, that there was something more fun to play with there. And then a journey to go on through the gaze of someone you're in love with that breaks you down.
He had so many great ideas about the texture of his characters and the texture of the journey of Maren and Lee. So we spent time thinking of the characters, not only his characters, and thinking of the infrastructure of the story.
Like, for instance, when Lee finds this album from The Kiss, he had this intuition that in that moment, Lee becomes unaware and starts to dance freely in front of Maren, not knowing that he's already triggering a loving relationship there. And for me, that's an experiment that is great.
I don't want to hurt anybody.
Famous last words.
Great. Glorious. Wow. And I like the line. The line is great.
As a filmmaker, I follow my instinct and I try to make sure that I really put the camera in the only place that I think is worthed. It helps me a lot to have actors that have this really iconic presence.
He's an auteur in that sense. He's directing from the point of view that he feels viscerally and no one else's. He's so on his path that you are a watercolor in the greater painting. And it's so thrilling as an actor to get to be adjacent to that and in front of it because it feels rare.
We went through this incredible journey of promotion of Call Me By Your Name and the success of the movie, his personal success, and the beautiful gallery of characters that he has been making since then has been so inspiring to me. I want to make more characters with him that are as profound and as surprising as the ones we made already.